Berks Community Action Program on BCTV is supported by the Berks Community Action Program.
Good morning. I'd like to welcome you to the Berks Community Action Program on BCTV. My name is Jodi Readinger. I'm BCAP's Community Relations Coordinator. We are live the first day of October, Tuesday, October 1st. It's supposed to be pumpkin spice days, but we're still a little bit warm outside. I am thrilled to have with me one of my coworkers as a guest, Stephan Fains, who's our Promoting Responsible Fatherhood Coordinator. He's got an exciting new, project that's starting up again this October. Before we get started, though, what does October mean besides like Halloween and pumpkin and cider? It's Oktoberfest time. BCTV every year has their Oktoberfest auction. This year it is... Okay. The kickoff's the 11th, so it starts the 14th? Yeah, starts the 14th. The 14th through the 18th. Live here on BCTV, they auction off all kinds of goodies, gift cards and gift baskets and pretty fun trips and things like that. So I usually come out and try to volunteer one night. We have people that come in and answer the phones. The online catalog is available right now. So you can go on to BCTV, check out the online catalog, sign up for your bidder number, all kinds of things. And I am so thrilled because one of the best parts of my job, Stephan, you and I have some pretty cool jobs sometimes. We have a pretty cool job. But one of the best parts of my job is when we're able to collaborate and something comes together. So BCTV is such an important part of what we do at BCAP because it gets the word out on so many of our programs. And their staff is wonderful and cooperative. We've had a representative on our board for many years, so we always try to support Oktoberfest. So as a producer, I said last month, I said, what kind of stuff goes at Oktoberfest? And they said, well, booze always goes. I know nothing about booze. But then I remembered that I have a friend that does sales for Stony Run Winery, which is a fairly new winery in Kempton. They're open on weekends, and their wines are sold over at Redner's in Kenhurst and Wyomissing. So she graciously donated 2 bottles of wine. And I actually picked up another bottle. So we've got 3 bottles of wine in the basket. One of my coworkers, Miss Teresa, thank you so much, Teresa, put together the basket for me. She hand-painted the picture on the front. So the basket contains 3 bottles of wine and a spaghetti dinner, some pasta and sauce and cheese. You got wine glasses. So you got, you know, dinner date in a basket. Turn on some Netflix or something like that. But this will be auctioned off on BCTV as part of the Oktoberfest auction. So I certainly hope that you'll tune in for that. It's the biggest fundraiser of the year for BCTV. Everybody that works here and volunteers here is great, but there are some costs involved with what they do. So they do try to raise that money every year. So October 14th to October 18th, the online catalog is on now. But this basket is so cool because it was a collaborative effort by so many people. So big shout out to Teresa who put it together and my friend Kate who does sales for Stony Run Winery and obviously Stony Run Winery who helped put the basket together. So we're really looking forward to seeing this get auctioned off and all the other goodies. I haven't visited the catalog yet. I just got the email this morning. But there's always all kinds of good stuff and presents. So definitely. All right. We did enough of an ad now, Stephan. Hopefully you filed that away with, oh, I need a Christmas present for my wife and my mom, and we'll get you tuning into the auction. The kids are so spoiled by their relatives, right?
Yeah.
So, fatherhood has been doing something. You were doing it this spring. I called it a fatherhood forum. I think you have a different name for it. But tell me a little bit about what's going on.
We'll be doing the starting October 15th, which would be the third Tuesday of every month, we'll be doing fatherhood engagement classes. And not even really classes, but a bunch of, you know, Head Start fathers from BCIU and some of the fathers that we have in BCAP. We're going to be just showing some fathers what are some things to do with your children when it's just alone time with dad or activities. Or a lot of the guys aren't from the community, they're new to the community. So just teaching them the ropes of the city about the Olivet Boys and Girls Club, the PAL, the REC. You know, things and programs that they can get their kids in and different things like that.
Oh, that sounds really interesting because kids don't come with an instruction manual.
Oh, they sure don't. They definitely don't.
You definitely know that. And being new to the area, it is so hard to develop all those contacts. And I know we try to share a lot of stuff on our Facebook page and, mm-hmm. and in our reception area about things that are low cost and inexpensive for the families to do. But it's hard to find all that. And I grew up here, and I'm still finding stuff that
I didn't know about.
Oh, that sounds...
So we serve the guys, you know, coffee and donuts in the morning. And we just really just talk about being men and fathers and just everybody, what are your interests and what are you looking for? We kind of just try to do it that way, not so structured. Just what do you guys need? What do you guys want? And then we try to go from there.
And that's so important, and that's such a big part of what BCAP does, is meeting people where they are.
Yes.
Our local solutions to local problems.
Yeah.
And with the fathers, you know, everybody knows that women gossip, but men don't always have that outlet or that chance or feel comfortable.
Yeah, unless they're in the barbershop or something like that. So, you know, that's like the feel I try to go for is like the barbershop feel, where just talk and let it out and say what you feel, and we'll try to figure things out some way, somehow. Just as, because like you said, there's no blueprint. So we're all people just trying to figure out how to be dads, how to be men, how to be. So it's good for all of them. And then sometimes one of the guys that take over, like last year we had a guy who did money management.
Okay.
So he was able to teach some of the guys about finances and saving your money and doing things like that. You know, so it worked really well.
Oh, that's exciting, and it's great when people step up and say, oh, I know something about this, let me share.
Oh, that's awesome, because then I get to let them teach, and I can let them do what they want for a little bit.
Oh, that's great. So you said this is in conjunction with the BCIU?
Yep, partnered up with the BCIU. It started off with, they just had a lot of fathers who were bringing their kids to Head Start that just didn't know what to do with their kids when they pick them up, and it's just them two at home, and just what ideas to do with a young kid, and you know, other than give them a tablet or put them on a PlayStation or something. They wanted to know, like, what can I do, you know? And I had a lot of fathers that are speak different languages, so they wanted to know, like, what other things can I do to better my English and do things like that as well. So, you know, we got to teach guys also, too, how to be better with their kids and learning some English and learning some different strategies. So it's I'm learning, too.
Oh, that sounds really exciting. Yeah. And you made such a great point. You know, while sometimes people look at us to answer their questions, we often learn
from
the people across the desk from us mm-hmm. as we can share with them. Mm-hmm. And that's a really important attitude that we have at BCAP and something I'm so thankful I have that ability. Mm-hmm. You can learn from everybody. Wow, so all kinds of stuff going on. So they're classes, but they're not, huh?
Yes, they're not. We hold them in the conference room at Berks Community Action Program, 645 Penn Street, third floor. Anyone can come. You know what I mean? It doesn't just have to be BCIU fathers. Any father who wants to learn something new or has something to teach or anything, we're just trying to open all doors to anyone who's looking for any kind of help. At our offices, third Tuesday of the month, of every month.
At 9:30.
9:30 to 11.
9:30 to 11. Yeah. And I think dads sometimes don't get credit. So, you know, and since our fatherhood program has changed again at BCAP, I notice myself, you know, picking out single dads or dads with their kids and you know, sometimes even going up to them and saying, you know, wow, you know, this is something your kid's going to remember. You know, we've got this program at BCAP mm-hmm. if you need any help and things like that, because it's so important for dads to engage. And
a lot of them are taught that just be the money and yell and you're doing okay. You know, so that's something that we're working on, is no, it's okay to be the dad and play and do things. You don't have to just be discipline and dollars. You can be everything.
You're more than a wallet?
Yeah, you're more than just a wallet and someone who yells at everybody, you know? So it's fun to teach them that, because a lot of them were taught that their dad was that. And so they just mock their dad, mm-hmm. but they don't want to because they didn't like the way their dad acted. So, you know, it's just good learning how to be men and learning that just being macho all day doesn't make you a man, you know, just because you're tough all day. You know, so it's a lot of fun just learning the different guys, the different cultures of different people and what they think of how to raise a kid. You know, like I said, we're just teaching each other all the time.
Oh, that sounds pretty exciting. So you're looking at all kinds of opportunities for activities to do with kids. And I know we've talked about, you know, some things that the parents can take home with them and the dads. And it's so great that they're not just putting them in front of the TV and really looking for ways to engage. Because, I mean, all my father did was work. So to spend time with him, you were working, which was okay because it's developed a work ethic in me that, you know, I probably wouldn't have otherwise.
And you're a numbers genius.
My dad was incredibly good with numbers. But it's so important, that relationship between father and child and fostering that. And so that sounds like a really exciting adventure. So that's the third Tuesday of every month. Mm-hmm. Any father is more than welcome to join in, 9:30 to 11 in the BCAP offices, talking about fatherhood challenges, talking about activities you can do with your kids. And even through this, you did a Fatherhood Day in June, too, out with the Berks Community Health Center, right?
Yeah. We had a day for the dads with Berks Community Health Center on Rockland, where a lot of the guys that worked with us, they were able to come with their families, get free haircuts, health screenings. You know, just because a lot of dads are taught that's mom's job. You know, right. Mom does doctors, everything like that. Dad, you do sports. Like, it's, you know, and it's, we got to learn that there's really no roles. Whoever's available, you take the kid here, you take the kid here. Not, well, it's a doctor's appointment, so it's on you. And, you know, so it's just a lot of that. And it was fun, you know, even it was fun to see the kids see their dads in that mode of, oh, wow, dad, you're out here, you're getting a haircut too, and you're looking for work, and you're doing everything we're doing. So it was, you know, it was, they got to bond some. And that's what we like to do with the fatherhood program mostly, is just try to create opportunities where dads and kids could be together and do some things that they normally wouldn't do.
Oh, that's pretty neat. And we share a lot of stuff about different things that are coming up. I know this weekend is the is an event out at the Heritage Center on 183. So we always try to be, last weekend we were at up in Leesport at Easy Does It with the Sober Stock, and there's all kinds of fun and low-cost activities in the area if you look for them and find them.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
And even this time of year, as it cools off, you know, just a walk in the park or different fun things. You know, I know with my dad, it was, we would get up early in the summer because he had to be at work early. He had his own business, and Dunkin' Donuts, you know, on a Thursday or a Friday morning. So I always, get a little smile and a tear in my eye when I'm in Dunkin' Donuts down from our office, and I see a dad there with his daughter and, you know, remember, because can't call dad up for a donut anymore.
Yeah.
But, so what else, so you've got your fatherhood forums or fatherhood classes. What else does our fatherhood program do? I know I always...
Well, on a daily basis, you know, we're just meeting the people where they're at, whatever needs they have. We do our, you know, the hygiene kits every day. If anybody needs soap, deodorant, socks, a t-shirt, anything like that, we have a community closet in there where Jodi helps me get everything all the time. She's always doing that, so that makes it easy for me because I just collect it and give it out. Jodi goes and shops and gets everything. So we do things like that in there. A lot of one-on-one just talking about being a dad and being a father. Because, I mean, like we said earlier, men don't really have a place to go where they feel comfortable to just talk about their feelings. So a lot of times I just be telling them, listen, you're a human. If you're sad today because you're upset about your kid, that is okay. You know, it's a lot of just teaching men it's okay to be a person. And being a man doesn't mean you never shed a tear and you're never sad. And, you know, it's a lot of me learning that, like, wow, men really believe this stuff. Yeah. You know, so it's a lot of teaching that it's okay to just be a guy who's learning and doesn't have it all in order and doesn't have it all together. So, like, that's the best part of it, just learning that everyone kind of goes through the same thing, no matter what level you're on, homeless or anything. Being a father is universal, and no matter what level you're at, it could be the same as another guy. So it's just a lot of that, of teaching, learning, coaching. And like I said, they teach me all the time. So that's the main thing I love about it, is just teaching every day. And I get that barbershop feel of, we talk about sports, we talk about politics, we talk about, you know, if they're just having a bad day, we'll sit in there. Yeah. Until their day is a little better and just go about it, you know. So it depends on what the guy wants and what the guy needs.
Right. And that, you know, meeting them where they're at and whatever they need. And BCAP is very fortunate with our fatherhood program to actually have a father leading it. So many of them across the state, you know, as happens in social services, are led by women.
Well, yeah, I learned that last year going to the trainings and stuff like that where most of them are women, you know, and I learned like, whoa, I ended up kind of like teaching a class at the last training, like, because they're all asking me, well, why do these guys act like this and why? And I'm like, well, guys aren't comfortable telling a woman how they, it's, you know, even in my fatherhood engagement, I've learned that where I tried to have women translators come and the men just, it just affected them in a way. And, you know, I'm telling them, man, don't worry about them women, but different cultures have different ways they see things. And, you know, it's just even learning that type of stuff where, wow, that I didn't think that would be an issue, but I guess it is, and then learning from there. So it's a learning experience every day.
Okay. I know I always, when I talk about the fatherhood program, you know, I couch it as getting a guy what he needs to be a man before he can step up to be a father. So we are just so fortunate to have the flexibility to do that kind of stuff.
For sure.
Because it's not all about numbers, it's about people.
Yeah.
And you know, we let our boss and administration worry about the numbers. We're gonna do our job, we'll give you what we need, but we're gonna worry about the numbers. So that's really exciting with the fatherhood stuff going on. So you've also been doing a lot with CareerLink too, with job finding and...
Over this last year, year and a half, we have a partnership with CareerLink called the WIOA One-Stop Shop, where it's all the community partners where, you know, anyone who's doing any CSBG funding and things like that, we all partner up at the CareerLink because we all do job search assistance. So I'm always taking guys up to CareerLink and I'm referring them there, or they're sending me referrals for people who need help after work. So it's just a perfect partnership to where guy needs a job, okay, CareerLink has everything and they'll help you. Or guys receiving unemployment, CareerLink can do a lot of the things that I was doing myself. So now partnering with them, I could be like, oh, okay, yeah, I could take you to CareerLink and they can help you with that and I can help you with this. Instead of CareerLink trying to do one whole thing or me trying to do one whole thing, that partnership definitely helped a lot.
And so like I was saying with the basket, you know, it's so great when everybody works together.
It makes it easier. It makes it, and it shows the community that, look, we're all together to help you. It's just a better feeling. It makes it smoother process.
And sometimes different personalities too. My husband and I have volunteered in different arenas and we work very well together as a team because I can do the nice social service stuff and he's a little bit more stern and like, I'm not putting up with what you're telling me. I've been where you are. But we've always made a really good team because it's two different approaches. And it usually, you know, either one of them will work.
Yeah.
So it's great when we have the partnership. And I know you've been doing a lot with your CareerLink. We've been doing a lot with job postings and things like that.
Yeah.
And getting to the point where some of these employers know you, so you can, if you recommend someone for a job.
Yeah, but it takes a lot to get a recommendation from me. It takes a lot. But I do it, but you got to earn that.
Well, and that's another, you know, thing we talk about, I talk about at BCAP all the time. If you walk in that door and you're ready,
oh my God,
to make a change, you know, we will do everything we possibly can.
We try to make it happen by the end of that day. if you're serious, we try to be as serious as you are. That's what we do. Yeah.
So, you know, we provide as much motivation as we can, but some of it's got to come from within. Mm-hmm. But that's a great service we do. Because I don't do a lot of direct client services, I get the warm and fuzzy and the nice stuff. You know, our Work Ready program with the young women and young men that come in, that have to do community service hours, I get a chance to see them when they come in, see them when they're there, and when they're ready to leave or when they've gotten a job, so I can share in that success. But I don't have to do all the paperwork. But it's just so important that we work as a team and that people know that there's a lot of people in your corner. You
for
know,
sure.
It's not just, you know, somebody pushing the pencil at their desk. We really, you know, when you get that GED, I'm jumping up too.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, when you get that job, the tears come in my eyes because we've seen how hard you work. And that's what makes us come back day after day after day for those large paychecks like Bill Martin said, right? It is definitely a labor of love.
Yeah.
So we're talking about fatherhood today. BCAP has a Promoting Responsible Fatherhood program. We've had that for several years. Stephan Fains is the coordinator of that program. And it provides services that gentlemen need to make them able to better prepare for their fatherhood role, whether it be something simple like an ID or transportation to a job, an apartment listing, or whether it be, you know, a couple hours sitting and talking and getting some information on, you know, some good dad advice.
And we also give guys kicks in the butt, too, you know. So if you have a father that needs a kick in the butt and he's not doing what you think he should do, send him in. I mean, we want to help everybody help themselves. That's basically what we want to do.
And when I do talk to female groups, I do say that. and so many times, I mean, you talked about the male dynamic, but I know especially with my husband, if I suggest something, you know, but if another guy suggests it, you know, it's like the Holy Grail.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Now, do you get instructions from any of the women in these guys' lives?
They try. They try to tell me how he should be behaving and how he should be acting. And, you know, that's always fun to hear when I go talk to the women groups. And they're like, well, why does he do this? And why is he doing that? And men are big bullies sometimes. And, you know, but it's even that. I like talking to the women group so I can hear how women think of men, too. And then I'm like, oh, wait. It just seems like everybody just needs to have a conversation. Because you think this and you think that. If everybody has a conversation, then we can see what everyone's thinking. But it's like everyone just thinks that there's these roles to play. I'm the mom. I do this. I do that. I do that. You're the dad, so you should do this. You should do that. But no one talks about the roles. You just assume someone should do it. But once you talk about it and you both do it, it just makes the family better.
And that's such a good important. Communication is such a key in every relationship. And sometimes you need to communicate not so much with your spouse, but you need a place to vent. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of what your yeah. fatherhood class is yeah. and your fatherhood forum. Because other people have had that same problem. And mm-hmm. I know when my husband and I first got together, I'd be like, oh my God. You know, like going to the office, why does he do this? Like, you know, like they yeah. ask you. And then yeah. I know Stephan gets that, you know, they has to answer for every man in the universe.
Oh, my goodness.
We're frustrated with our husbands.
Yeah.
But we speak different languages, and it's important that we communicate with each other, but it's also important that we have somebody else saying, you know, hey, you know, maybe this will work, or maybe that'll work.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, fatherhood is different for everybody, but it's not reinventing the wheel.
Right.
You can definitely get tips and hints and things like that. So we're down to the end of our show. So a great grain of advice from our fatherhood guru?
Just try your best. I mean, that's what I try to... So many dads are hard on themselves for not being a specific thing, you know? And it's... I always try to tell those guys, everything I'm doing right now, I never even thought I'd be doing. So stop being so hard on yourself, and it's going to work itself out. You just got to try your best, and you're still going to fail, but you'll be all right. You know, that's basically what I try to tell them every day.
Well, and that's important for the kids to see, too.
Yeah.
You know, that not everything goes smoothly, that there are ups and downs. And I know so much of what my parents sacrificed, I never realized until
mm-hmm.
I became an adult.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and things that were never discussed, and but it's very important to show your kids the ups and the downs.
Yeah, so they see the work you're putting in. I think a lot of parents don't realize that your kids do see you. They see you. They just don't understand. You're working all day, but when they grow up, they're just like, wow, wait. So dad worked 12-hour days. I mean, this is why. So you know, it works itself out in the end.
Okay. So it's time to say goodbye. I want to thank Stephan for joining me today.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. Plug again, Oktoberfest, October 14th through 18th. All kinds of auction prizes to be won. The online catalog is available. So I'd like to thank BCTV. I'd like to thank Stephan again. And for everyone at BCAP, where we believe a neighbor in need is a call to action. Thank you very much.